Everyone, today we are here to talk about cockpit crew pilots hiring HK Express Airlines. My name is Vandika Lamba. I am a co-founder of Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. You can find us on www.aircruiseaviation.com. My details are there in front of you. You can find us on our social media, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Insta for more information on our website. Today we're going to talk about HK Express. We're going to talk about their meanings, requirements, benefits, and what are the general questions and answers which are asked. Let's talk about what is HK Express. This is Hong Kong Express Airways Limited, commonly known as Hong Kong Express, or just you can say HK Express. It is a Hong Kong based, it's a low cost airline which is fully owned by Cathay Pacific Airways. It provides scheduled air services to 27 destinations in India, including China, Japan, Korea, Cambodia, Vietnam, US territories, Taiwan, and Thailand. The parent organization of HK Express is Cathay Pacific. CEO is Mandy Ng. She is present from August 2009 till present. The headquarters of HK Express is in Tung Chung, which is in Hong Kong. It flies to 27 destinations and the hub is Hong Kong International Airport. Let's talk about their requirements. What are they looking for? Languages, English. What they require is 1,000 hours of total flying experience, 500 hours flying experience as a first officer on CS-25 aircraft, or you have 2,000 hours of total flying experience, 500 flying experience on multi-crew aircraft. What they also need is ICAO ATPL, which is known as Airline Transport Pilot License, or frozen ATPL, which is known as CPL with ATPL subjects. You need to have current MEIR, which is known as Instrument Rating Multi-Engine Land, FCC, which is Federal Communications Commission Restricted Radio Permit, ICAO Class 1 Flight Crew Medical Certificate, ICAO Level 4 Proficiency in English Language, and for CPL holders, 5 hours of total night flying experience as pilot in command. Let's talk about their benefits. HK Express pilots will no longer get paid for at least 50 flying hours a month in productivity pay and will instead receive a basic salary, wages for actual flying hours and allowances. A captain with more than 3,000 hours of experience will see basic fall to Hong Kong $57,000 a month from Hong Kong $75,000. Let's talk about the common question and answers which are generally asked. According to you, what defines a professional pilot? Someone who has knowledge, punctuality, effective, and excellent communication skills. Well understandable, willful in continuing training, and very systematic. Let's talk about the importance of proficiency in a number of languages for a pilot. Those pilots who fly privately only require understanding control towers. Knowing only English can be just enough, but for pilots who need to fly publicly in a regular basis must be fluent in languages other than English. This then becomes an added advantage for the pilot in handling situations. Pilots are required to take many simultaneous responsibilities during flight. Say something about this. See, it is the key responsibility of the pilots to navigate the flight, monitor, and guide his team of crew members, check and maintain the required technical instruments, as well as keep the regular track of the weather condition, at the same time controlling the height and air traffic. Could be a pilot's role during an emergency? That's a very important question which is generally asked. What is a pilot's role during an emergency, which is a very important role? An answer to this question should be express your feelings first. It would be best to prove, citing examples, that you will be able to keep your mental calmness. It generally states that you need to be calm, you need to be patient, and how you deal with an emergency. Do you ever have to modify the flight course? Depending on the internal or external conditions, pilots are trained enough and able to reform the course in flight. Modification of the flight course is very vital responsibility and requires close contact with control towers and attention to detail. Basically, it's a set standard of courses which is being educated to all the pilots. How would you assess your success in this job? There are a number of ways in which you could assess your success in this field. You set big challenges for yourself and met them. The achievements you gained counts as your big success. Your boss told you that you had done a great performance. All those achievements, cards, rewards, and awards will speak about your success. And don't forget, more you are, the more is the success. What type of work environment do you prefer? You should answer this question by mentioning that you enjoy a fast-paced, collaborative work environment. And if you tell the interview that you like to work alone and that you're typically like a very slow environment, it could cost you the job. You can read a full article on how to answer what type of work environments do you prefer. Now, let's say if they ask you about your great strengths, you can say, I actually pick strengths that are related to the job. Basically, what will convince the interview that I'm likely to succeed in this position? What languages do you speak? This is a straightforward question and you should reply by stating all the languages. Just be frank, just be clear what all languages you speak and communicate. What do you mean by V1? It means take off decision speed. V2, it means take off safety speed. In a situation when the ground crew is running behind or was busy with another job, would you be your role in loading the airplane with boxes? In such a situation where the ground crew needs my help, I would of course stand by him and help load the airplane with boxes. It's generally say that like it's like a teamwork. It's not that like she's busy or he's busy. So yes, it's like a teamwork. What do you do? What do you mean by LDA? A precision approach that is offset from the runway is known as localizer type directional aid. It may have GR. How your current boss would like to describe you? He describes my qualities as a dedicated team player who always looks to make a difference. In your opinion, what qualifies make a good pilot? A good pilot takes his or her job seriously and it is a good risk evaluator, not a risk taker. He is the one who consistently carries his able attributes as his personal baggage on each and every flight. What was your motto behind becoming a pilot? Try listing the reasons behind you becoming a pilot for him and cite 2-3 most strongest of them. What are the 3 most vital things you must report before entering into a hold? Expect the further clearance time, the time of arrival at the holding fix, and altitude needs to be reported on time. What lesson you have achieved from mistakes from your pilot job? You have to be very honest about such a question. Your answer has to be brief and to the point. You cannot tell a lie that your career has been flawless. You need to be very clear and very precise. Your answer reflecting a positive aspect where you have learned from your mistake will be an added advantage. You can say as a sample, I'm a constant learner and I prefer learning even from my mistake. My mistakes in a career have made me more alert and confident. It gonna talks about your confidence level, your positivity and your nature. So these are the questions we have summed up, which are basically asked in an interview. So you can refer to these questions for your better understanding. What were your actions to improve your pilot knowledge in the previous years? Here you should be answering that you include the improvement activities that he or she has done to do the job in the previous years. Like you can frame it in an answer like, I'm a person who prefers to learn in a continuous process and also learn more deeply from my mistakes. My learning enhances with discussion with seniors and experienced fellows in the field as well. I prefer to regularly upgrade myself with new courses and new certifications. Point out your biggest weakness. That is the most commonly question asked. So that is the most tricky and obvious question to be asked in an interview. So if you're going to answer to this question that you don't have any weakness, so it clearly says that you are lying, because everyone, including me, everyone in this world has some weaknesses. So a personal weakness description would you put in is a false position. A mention of weakness may reveal a point which might not be beneficial. So as an example, You can say my weakness is you are emotional, you are maybe a constant, you like books or something. So that kind of weakness you can say, that depends on you what goes as per the interview. Say something about your achievements. By this question, the employer wants to understand about your work skill. You have to answer on work-based achievements mainly. Here you have to exhibit those things in your career of which you are proud of. You have to point your key achievements, like you can say communication, teamwork, and presentation. What do you rate yourself in handling situation at stress and work pressure? Your rating should be justified. You can't say I'm 10 on 10. So it should be justified. Never say that you get panicked easily or I cannot work under pressure. Just you can just mention this with examples how you have handled the situations. Basically, your answer would add stars if you mention cases where you have handled some tough situations, where you have sought some expert advice and guidance, and where you have learned some lessons, which showcases your inclination towards betterment. What does the MSA circle on the approach plate mean and mention its use? The lowest altitude that provides at least 1,000 feet obstruction or terrain clearance within 25 miles of grade it is based off. This is used for emergency purpose only and does not always adhere to signal coverage. How does radiation fog form? Heat is radiated from the ground. After the ground starts radiating the heat into the atmosphere, it has accumulated during the entire day under the sun. The ground has the capacity to quickly cool down overnight, and the air just above the ground space cools immediately as well. A presence of moisture in it cools to its dew point, thus forming fog. What work situation excite and motivate you? I am most motivated on the job when tasks are organized and the vibe is positive. I really value strong teamwork and good leadership. When have you had to shift your priorities in response to sudden changes? In my current role, our schedule is changed on a regular basis and always at short notice. I have been able to adapt very well to these frequent and sudden changes. So these are some of our books, Most Successful Female Entrepreneurs of India, Pilot's Career Guide, which is easily available on Amazon. If you would like to have more career options on Air Hostess or a career guide, you can go on to the website Amazon and look for these books. These are the books we have on Amazon. Thank you so much, and my details are there. If you would like to get in touch with us for any more information, suggestions, we are there to help you. Thank you.